Hello, and welcome to EPA's Energy Star Portfolio Manager Demonstration Series. EPA's free online Energy Star Portfolio Manager tool is the industry standard for measuring and tracking energy performance within commercial buildings. Today, we'll discuss how to track renewable electricity that is generated at your facility. In order to understand the requirements for entering on-site green power into Portfolio Manager, let's review some key concepts and terms. We'll start by reviewing this diagram, which identifies the various flows of energy that exist in an on-site renewable generation scenario and that need to be captured on Portfolio Manager. Don't worry, this may look complicated, but we are going to walk through each step together so that you will have a clear understanding of how this applies to benchmarking your building in Portfolio Manager. It is important to remember that many of the terms used in this presentation are specific to Portfolio Manager's inputs, and that your utility bill may use other names to indicate these values. If you have any questions about what a specific term on your utility bill means, you should ask your utility. In this diagram, we are assuming that electricity is being generated on-site via a solar photovoltaic system, but this could just as easily be an on-site wind turbine. The generation meter shown in this diagram captures the total quantity of energy produced by the system. It is expected that all on-site systems will be able to capture this total generation value and will be able to obtain values for specific date ranges in order to align with utility billing periods. For our purposes, we will refer to this as value G. Not all energy generated on-site will necessarily be used by the building. If at any moment more energy is being generated than is required to operate the building, this excess generation may be sold back to the grid. For this reason, you will see that the diagram differentiates between flow A, which is the amount of energy generated on site and used on site, and flow B, which is the amount of energy generated on site and exported to the grid. As we will see, being able to differentiate these values is important to accurately assess the energy performance of your property. Unless a building is completely off the grid, it is expected to consume at least some electricity from the grid in order to meet the building's needs during times when the building requires more electricity to operate than the on-site system can provide. For a solar photovoltaic system, this could mean nighttime operation, cloudy days, or hot days when the building's cooling load exceeds what the on-site system is able to generate. In our diagram, energy received from the grid is indicated as flow C. Therefore, the total electricity consumed on-site at a building with renewable power generation can be defined as flow C, grid electricity, plus flow A, energy generated on-site and used on-site. Excess electricity generation sent back to the grid, or flow B, is measured by the utility meter before leaving the premises. However, many utilities do not provide this value on the utility bill that goes to the customer. In such cases, the utility only provides customers with the net metered consumption, or N, which is equivalent to flow C, grid electricity, minus flow B, energy generated on site and exported to the grid. A net metered value and its associated cost may be positive or negative in a given month. It is important to note, however, that the concept of net metering is primarily related to billing and does not provide complete insight as to the actual energy consumption required to operate a building. Even if a building is showing negative net metered consumption in a given month, and the customer is getting a billing credit because it sold back more energy than it consumed from the grid, the building would still have had to consume a positive amount of grid electricity during this period. In order to accurately benchmark your building, you need to know or be able to calculate the total consumption from the grid, not just the net value. Entering the net metered value as your grid electricity use will under-account for the building's total grid electricity consumption. You may be wondering, why do we need to track all of these energy flows? The answer is that Portfolio Manager differentiates between the energy you consume from the grid and the energy you consume from on-site generation. Essentially, your energy metrics are getting a credit for on-site renewable electricity consumption compared to grid electricity consumption. So it's important to be able to differentiate the two. Let's take a look at how these values might appear on a utility bill. In this example, the utility bill provides all of the energy flows that we need to benchmark correctly in Portfolio Manager. This bill shows current usage, which equates to flow C, or total grid electricity consumption. It indicates the amount of energy that was generated on site and exported back to the grid, flow B, which the utility refers to as current generation. And it also shows net usage billed, which equates to the net metered consumption value, or C minus B. In addition, because this property has an on-site generation meter, we can calculate the total amount of energy generated on site during the utility billing period, value G. This value, minus the amount exported to the grid, flow B, or current generation in this case, is equivalent to flow A, the amount of energy generated on site and used on site. This value doesn't show up on the utility bill, but we will need to know it when it comes time to enter data into Portfolio Manager. Now let's look at a new example, where the utility is only providing the metered consumption value, which they call net usage on this particular bill. This means that the only values we have are the net metered consumption, C minus B, and total on-site energy generation, A plus B. Unfortunately, these values alone are not sufficient for complete and accurate benchmarking, since even though you can calculate total site energy consumption, or A plus C, by adding these figures together, you will not have an accurate breakdown of the grid versus renewable energy that was actually consumed by the building. In a few minutes, we will discuss how to handle this situation. At this point, we're going to head directly into Portfolio Manager to review the proper configuration of meters to reflect on-site renewable energy consumption. If you need a refresher on how to set up properties or meters in Portfolio Manager, please visit the Energy Star trainings page at the URL shown on the screen. To get started, click the name of the property for which you'll be tracking on-site renewable energy consumption. From within the property record, click on the Energy tab, which is where we can manage the various meters that have been defined for our property. In our example, this building already has a grid electricity meter defined. However, when benchmarking a property that uses on-site generated renewable energy, you will need to have at minimum two electric meters set up in Portfolio Manager, one to reflect the energy received and consumed from the grid, and one to reflect the energy generated and consumed on-site. As we mentioned earlier, Portfolio Manager treats these two energy types differently when calculating energy performance metrics, and so the distinction is important. To add an on-site renewable electricity meter to this property, click Add Meter. From the list of available meter types, select Electric, which will present you with further options. Most notably, you can specify whether your electricity is purchased from the grid or is generated on-site from either solar panels or wind turbines. For this example, we will select Generated On-Site with My Own Solar Panels. Once you have selected the appropriate meters, click Get Started. On this page, you can update the meter name. You will select the units in which your electricity consumption is measured, typically kilowatt hours, and indicate that the meter is in use by checking the appropriate box. You will also be asked to enter the date meter became active. Typically, this will be the first day of the first consumption entry that you will be entering for this meter. After entering all of the necessary information, click Create Meters. Before we move ahead and entering meter consumption entries, though, let's take a look back at the Energy tab. As you can see, we now have our two electricity meters set up for this property. We are ready to enter our consumption data for both grid electricity and on-site generated solar electricity. You can do this by clicking directly on the meter name or by clicking the Enter Your Bills button in the meter summary box. We'll start by entering data from our first utility bill example, the one that included all of the data flows we need to benchmark in Portfolio Manager. Let's start with our electric grid meter. First, you will enter the start date and end date of the billing period as defined by the utility. From our sample utility bill, we know that current usage is the electricity consumed from the grid, or flow C, in our diagram. This is the value that we will record as usage in Portfolio Manager. And even if this utility bill only displayed current generation, B, and net usage billed, C minus B, we could still use this information to manually calculate the value for C. When you are done, click Save. Next, we need to account for the energy consumption associated with our on-site renewable energy generation. To do this, you can select that meter from the drop-down list on the Manage Bills page. Or, if you've already returned to the Energy Bills tab, simply click on the meter name. First, define the date range for this meter entry. This should align with the period you previously entered for the grid electricity meter. From the utility bill, we know that current generation is equivalent to flow B on the Energy Star diagram. This value should be entered in the field labeled Energy Exported Offsite. To obtain energy used on site, or flow A, we need to do some quick math. This value will be equivalent to the total on-site renewable energy generation for the period in question, value G, which should be available via the on-site solar photovoltaic system, minus the energy exported off-site, or flow B. In our case, this is 2,346 kilowatt hours. You also have the option to indicate whether the renewable energy credits, or RECs, associated with on-site renewable energy generation have been retained or sold. In this example, we're going to assume that the RECs have been retained. This selection impacts the calculation of your property's greenhouse gas emissions metrics, but not your energy performance metrics. And we're done. We have only demonstrated how to enter a single month's worth of data here, but you would follow the same process for any additional months. In the end, we are properly accounting for the energy our building consumed from the grid, as well as the energy that was generated on site and consumed on site. This allows for the calculation of total site energy consumption while also capturing the correct breakdown between grid electricity and renewable electricity. Next, we will examine the scenario where the utility bill only provides net metered consumption without any further breakdown as to the total energy sent from the grid to the property or sent from the property back to the grid. In this case, the only energy consumption values available are G, corresponding to the total on-site renewable energy generation, and N, corresponding to the net metered consumption, which is equivalent to C minus B. However, without any additional data points, you cannot use this information to calculate either the total grid electricity consumption, C, or the amount of energy generated on site and exported off site, B. A common mistake in this scenario is for Portfolio Manager users to enter the net metered consumption value as the usage within the grid electricity meter, and to enter the total on site renewable generation as energy used on site within the on-site solar electricity meter. However, this would over-account for the amount of renewable energy consumed at the property and under-account for the amount of grid electricity consumed. This will result in your Portfolio Manager 1 to 100 score being higher than it should be and your source energy use intensity metric being lower than it should be. If you applied for Energy Star certification for a property set up in this manner, this would be flagged as a potential issue. For this reason, it is recommended that Portfolio Manager users in this situation benchmark all of the building's electricity consumption, both grid and renewable, under the grid electricity meter. This is a conservative approach, as it keeps the property from receiving the credit associated with on-site renewable electricity as compared to grid electricity. But if a property benchmarked in this manner were to apply for Energy Star certification with a score of 75 or higher, it could be approved, since it is understood that the property's actual performance is higher due to the use of on-site renewable energy. As noted, we will enter total site energy consumption into the usage field of the electric grid meter. To calculate total site energy consumption, we must add the net metered consumption from our utility bill N to the total on-site generation from the same billing period G. In this scenario, we would not need to have a separate on-site solar meter defined, since we do not have the information necessary to populate it with the data that Portfolio Manager requires. Thank you for watching this demonstration. For more information about Portfolio Manager, including how-to guides and videos, live and recorded webinars, and frequently asked questions, please visit the websites listed here.